Dr. K. S. Ramakrishnan is working as an assistant professor, School of Education, Tamil Nadu Open University, Chennai 15. He has been teaching science education, environmental science, educational technology, and research methodology in various colleges of education and Tamil Nadu Open University for the past 9 years. He has guided so many M.Ed., M.Phil., and Ph.D. students. His current research areas are environmental education, educational technology, and media and communication. He has conducted various workshops on ICT usage in education, Wiki Educator, e-content development, and educational research methodology. He had attended many online workshops on Moodle, learning analytics. He has published 6 books and many articles in national and international journals of repute. He regularly gives plenary and keynote speeches on environment and ICT-related issues at various national and international conferences. He has delivered 28 episodes of the program Pudiyodor Ulagam at All India Radio, Chennai, related to various new developments in science and technology.
Welcome to UGC CUC program on environmental science. So, in this episode, we are going to discuss about the correlation and regression. So, these are another 2 statistical techniques that we have to discuss. So, these are all the topics that we are going to discuss today: the correlation, what are the types of correlation, regression, and multiple regression. So, there are so many statistical techniques available, and now depending upon the type of data, the conditions, and whether it is parametric or non-parametric, so all these are deciding what technique that we have to use. And accordingly, that the correlation is another technique. As we have already mentioned, correlation means there is a relationship between the 2 variables. And always remember, the correlation does not mean causation. If you want to prove that there are significant differences between the variable, then the correlation technique can be used, but we have to substantiate with by some other technique. But simply to know whether there are relationship are there, then the correlation technique is enough. And the second one, that is regression. And in case if there are 2 variables, one dependent and one independent variable, if you want to know what is the relationship between the independent and dependent variable by an equation, then we can go for the regression. And the multiple regression, that is an advancement of the regression. And therefore, my dear friends, today in this episode, we are going to discuss the correlation, the types of correlation, and the regression. So, let us start now. Correlation, it is the extent to which 2 variables are related or associated. That means, the extent to which the direction and the size of the deviations from the mean in 1 variable are related to the direction and size of deviations from the mean in another variable. That means, there are 2 variables that we are taking. Suppose, if this is 1 variable and another variable that we are taking, and by definition, it is telling about the direction and size. That means, which direction. Suppose, if 1 variable that is growing up, that means this direction, and another variable may be going down, and therefore this direction. And therefore, what is the relationship between these 2 variables and what is the direction? Suppose, if we are changing 1 variable, what is changed in the other variable? It is growing or it is coming down. And so, that particular information that the correlation is providing. So, the extent to which the direction and the size of deviations from the mean, and they are called the correlation. That means, the correlation is represented by a coefficient r, and that is given by summation over zx and zy, because these are all the 2 variables divided by n. Now, let us go into further. There are 4 types of correlation. And the patterns of relationship: positive, negative, curvilinear, and no relationship. See, for example, if you take, suppose if 1 variable that you are increasing, when the other variable is also increasing, that means it is a positive correlation. And the reverse correlation, suppose if one is increasing, the other is decreasing, that means it is negative correlation. And no correlation, that means if you are increasing or decreasing one variable, there is no change in the other variable, and therefore that is no correlation. And curvilinear, that means either it is not permanently increasing or permanently decreasing, and it is increasing and further decreasing, and therefore a pattern that it is following, and therefore these are all the four types of relationship: positive, negative, curvilinear and no relationship. So these are all the example. So suppose the number of pyrates and the global average temperature, and therefore here the number of pyrates and the average temperature, global temperature, the world temperature is calculated, and here as the it is increasing, and there it is also increasing, and therefore the relationship, that is a positive relationship. And now the other one, the negative relationship, the chlorophyll concentration, and here the Secchi depth, and therefore the chlorophyll concentration, as you are increasing the chlorophyll concentration, now the Secchi depth, and that goes on decreasing, and therefore here if one variable is increasing, the other variable is decreasing, and therefore the direction is negative, and therefore this is an example for negative correlation. And the third type, the curvilinear, here the x-axis we are increasing, but in the yield the y-axis, and here the stocking density, and here the yield, initially there is an increase and it has reached a saturation value, and after that there is a decrease, and therefore this is an example for curvilinear correlation. And the last one, there is no correlation at all, and here if you are increasing, one is increasing, another is decreasing, and therefore the net result will be something like this, and therefore here there is no relationship. And therefore, my dear friends, the correlation will tell you what is the relationship between two variables, whether it is increasing or whether it is decreasing, or whether it is curvilinear or there is no relationship. And now let us calculate it, how to find out the strength of the correlation. And so there are some formulae are there, and first the simple correlation coefficient, it is also called the Pearson's correlation or the product moment correlation. It measures the nature and strength between two variables of the quantitative type, because all these are the quantitative variables. And the sign of R denotes the nature of association, and the value denotes the strength, and therefore the sign positive or negative, and value 0.3, 0.4 or 0.7. So the value tells the strength and the sign tells the direction. And if the sign is positive, that means it is a positive correlation, that means a direct relation. If the sign is negative, that means an inverse relationship, that means when one is increasing, the other is decreasing, and therefore by putting the value, that we can easily find out what is the relationship between the two. Actually it is a continuum. The correlation can take value from -1 to +1, and in the middle 0, and therefore from 0, if you are taking +25, that means a weak correlation. That means if the correlation value is between 0 and 0.25, it is a weak correlation. 0.25 to 0.75, it is intermediate correlation, and it is strong correlation. And therefore on this side that we are taking the positive, on the negative side we take the reverse correlation, and therefore when it is a 0, that means there is no relationship at all, and therefore on the positive continuum, 0 to 0.25 weak, 0.25 to 0.75 intermediate, and 0.75 onwards it is strong. And therefore if you want to tell confirmedly that there is a relationship between these two variables, the correlation coefficient should be at least greater than 0.6. according to the statistical procedure. And the same thing is applicable for the reverse side also. And if it is minus 1 and plus 1, it is called perfectly correlation. That means it is perfectly increasing or decreasing. Now let us take the formula, and these are all already that we have seen. And now let us take the formula, what formula that we can use. So it is a product moment correlation, and all the terms are having their usual meaning. So x and y are the variable. So summation over xy minus summation x summation y by n, and summation of x square minus summation of x whole square by n into summation of y square minus summation y whole square by n. So all these are some common terms only, where x and y are the values of the variable, n is the number of terms, and x square and x bar, etc., etc. And therefore, the product moment correlation can be calculated by this formula. Now, we have to take an example and we have to put the values. Now, take an example. 6 children are taken, their age in years and their weight in kilogram. So, these are all the two variables and they are recorded. And therefore, here n is 6. And x1, x2, x3, they are the age, and y1, y2, y3, they are the weights. Now, we have to put into the formula x summation x 41, summation y, summation xy, summation x square, summation y square, and therefore, all the values that we have calculated, and now we are putting in the formula. And by putting into the formula, what we are getting, r is equal to 0.759. And therefore, we have to think of two parameters. One is the sign and another is the value. And the sign, that is plus, if nothing is written, plus. And therefore, the sign is plus, and therefore, you have to read it like that, plus 0.75. As we have seen in the diagram, the value tells that it is a strong correlation, and the sign tells that it is a positive correlation, and therefore, the correlation between these two variables, that is strong positive correlation. Now, another correlation called the rank correlation, and it is non-parametric, and therefore, it does not follow any distribution. And now, instead of using the value, that we are using their corresponding ranks, and therefore, it is much easier than the previous one, and therefore, it is sometimes called the rank correlation also. And now, let us take an example. What is the formula? And here, the rank correlation, there are some situation, both variables are quantitative and both variables are ordinal, and when one variable is quantitative and another variable is qualitative, and therefore, in all these three situations that we can use, when both are quantitative and one qualitative ordinal, and when one quantitative and another is qualitative ordinal. And therefore, in all these cases that we can use the Spearman rank correlation. And here, we have to first rank them, and we have to find the difference of rank, that is mentioned by di, and then we have to find out di square, and we have to apply into the formula 1 minus 6 into summation over di square by n into n square minus 1. So, the formula is much more simple, and therefore, this formula that is giving you the rank correlation. Let us have a short break. Welcome back. Now, let us take an example for the rank correlation. And here, these are all the subjects and the level of education, the preparatory, primary, etc., etc. And here, their income. And therefore, here also that we are having two quantities, the income and their level of education. And now, we have to tabulate it. and these are all the subjects, and here the income, and here the rank in X. So, we are ranking the income accordingly what is their corresponding rank, and here the rank Y, what is the rank. And here, instead of finding the difference between these two, we are finding the difference between the rank. Here you see one variable that is a quantitative variable and it is a qualitative variable. The preparatory, primary, university, secondary, all these are the qualitative variable and they are ordinal. Ordinal means they are following some sequence, and therefore, illiterate, primary, secondary and university. So, like that there are some grades are there, and therefore, it is a qualitative variable and it is a quantitative variable, but now also that we are able to find out the correlation, but in the product moment correlation this is not applicable because there both the values that we are taking, but here only the ranks that we are taking, and therefore, it is more much more comfortable than the previous one. And now, the procedure is very simple. We have to find out the rank of X, the rank of Y, and find out the difference of rank DI, and we have to find out the DI square, and we have to find out the summation of the DI square, and by putting into the formula, R is equal to 1 minus 6 into DI square by N into N square minus 1, and therefore, by putting into the formula, we are getting the value minus 0.1. And now, let us interpret it. The minus sign says that there is a negative correlation, and the 0.1 says that the correlation is somewhat weak, and therefore, we can conclude there is an indirect weak correlation. Indirect means negative. So, there is a negative weak correlation between the education qualification and their income. Therefore, as the education qualification and the income, there is not much correlation between these two, and therefore, by that way that we are finding what is the relationship between these two variables. But again that we have to be very cautious, it is not telling there is any cause and effect, because the educational level and income, they may cause each other or they may not, we do not know. But anyhow, by putting the correlation alone, we cannot come into a conclusion that one is causing the other. And therefore, these are all the examples that we have found out for the correlation analysis. And now, let us go into the regression. As we have already seen, the correlation and regression both are somewhat similar. That means, the correlation is telling the relationship between two variables by a single term, that means the correlational coefficient, and the regression is putting them in terms of an equation. That means the regression is a furtherance of correlation. So, it is a technique concerned with predicting some variable by knowing others. So, it is a process of predicting variable Y using variable X. And it uses a variable X to predict some outcome. That means, simply speaking, by finding the variations happening in X, how they are affecting Y. That means, what is the relationship between Y and X? If you are putting into an equation, that is called the regression equation. And therefore, the regression is a furtherance of correlation only. And therefore, here we are putting that into a function. Generally, it is a linear function, but it is not necessary that always it is linear. And therefore, the correlation describes the strength of a linear relationship. The regression tells us how to draw the straight line described by the correlation. So, it is telling us how to draw the straight line. And so, the straight line, we know that it is a straight line, but we have to know how to draw the equation, what is the slope of the curve and all that we have to intercept and all, and therefore, that is told by the regression. And now, let us take an example, and therefore, the equation form y is equal to, as we have seen, the equation for a straight line y is equal to mx plus c, and therefore, b into x plus a, and here B is called the slope, A is called the intercept, and therefore we are connecting x and y by an equation, and the equation is giving you the slope of the curve and the intercept, and therefore it is giving you the complete picture about the relationship and the regression equation. And here the regression equation, suppose there is a small change, and here we have taken x and there we have taken y, and what is the equation telling mathematically? If x is changed by a small amount x, then how much is changed in y? That means the slope is called the ratio between the y and x, and therefore how much change in y and how much change in x, that is called the slope of the curve. And this is called the intercept. Intercept means at the origin where the equation starts, and therefore this is called the intercept. And therefore in this equation, A tells at the origin what is the y coordinate, and B tells what is the slope of the curve, and all that we have seen. And now let us take an example, and here some data is given and the number of hours spent and the final grade, and therefore the data tells there is some positive correlation between these values. And now we have to put the regression, and therefore the predicted final grade that is given by the equation y is equal to 59.95 plus 3.17 into the number of hours you study, and therefore the relationship between these two variable is given by this equation, and here it is an intercept and it is a slope, and therefore this equation is called the regression equation. And now what is the interpretation? Suppose if someone is studying for 12 hours, then this equation says the final grade is equal to the intercept 59.95 plus 3.17 into 12, that means 97.99. That means it is much more easier to interpret, because if we know the time of study, then this equation says that the final score may be expected around 97.99. And in another case, 1 hour, that is equal to 63, and therefore it is much more easier to interpret the regression equation. As an example, that we are taking age as a variable and here the weight. So now our assignment is, what is the relationship between age and weight? And therefore age is given, the weight is given, and now we have to find out the regression equation. And the formula that is somewhat similar to correlation, and here x, y, and the product x, y, x square and y square, all that we have calculated, and we have to put into the formula. Now what is the formula? That is, B is equal to that the product 461 minus x bar and summation over y by n. So therefore, by putting into the formula, that we are getting that y is equal to 11 plus 0.9 into x minus 6.83. It is the intercept and it is the slope, and therefore we are getting the final equation, y is equal to 4.675 plus 0.92 into 75, that means 11.58. Therefore, the formula we have to put, y is equal to 4.675 plus 0.92 into x. And suppose if the value of x is given 8.5, suppose if the person's age, that is 7.5, and therefore how much weight that he will have, that is given by 4.675 plus 0.92 into 7.5, and that is equal to 11.58 kilogram. And so it is a relationship between the weight and the age, and therefore the relationship between the age and weight is given by this equation form, and therefore it is called the regression equation. And we can simply represent that by a graph also. And now multiple regression means, suppose if we have taken only one variable x, instead that we can take two or three variable, that is called the multiple regression, and therefore that will give you the linear relationship between three or more variables. Now let us summarize. In this episode we have dealt with various statistical tests, correlation, and two types of correlation, Pearson correlation and the rank correlation, and the regression. Some working examples for each one of the technique also have been discussed. Now let us have some question. Mention the types of correlation. The second one, which correlation technique is used when the data is in the form of ranks? The third one, what are the values taken by correlation coefficient? Briefly discuss them. That means that the correlation coefficient cannot take all the values, they can take only some value, and we have to analyze them. The fourth question, differentiate between correlation and regression. And the last question, what is multiple regression? So with that, we are concluding this episode. Thank you.